Let's solve the next problem in warm-up challenges under interview preparation kit on HackerRank. So next problem is repeated strings. So the problem says that Leela has a string S and it consists of only lowercase English letters, and she has repeated the string infinitely many times, and we are given an integer N and we have to find the count of letter small a in the first n letters of Leela's infinite string. For example, we have a, b, c, a, c, and n is 10. So what should be the count? Let's see. So we have a, b, c, a, c. So this string length is 5. We have 5 characters, but it is repeated infinitely many times. So it is a, b, c, a, c, then again a, b, c, a, c, again a, b, c, a, c, and so on. But we are given a number, let's say here 10. So we see that 5 is here because the length of a string is 5. And if we repeat the string again, then we get 10. And in the original string, we had 2 times a. So if the string is repeated twice, we will get 4 A's. So in this case, the answer is 4. How did we calculate that? We found a factor by how many times this string is repeated. So that will be N divided by length of a string. But in this case, N was perfectly divisible by this. There may be the case that N is 13, for example, in this case. So remove this not. So again, we will find this K, N upon length. So this is an integer, so it will return 2. And now the remainder will be n modulo len. So in this case, 13 modulo len is 3. So repeat the string 2 times and then take the r characters of this string. So this r will strictly be less than len, because it's just the modulo. So obviously, if we take modulo of a number, it will be less than this n. Now, for this, you see that you can keep a running count. So let's keep a variable, running count. It will keep track of till this position, how many a has occurred. So here we see that if we see till first position, a has occurred once. If we go here, again, from till this position, only one A has occurred. Till this position, also only one A has occurred. Till this position, 2 A has occurred. So, and till this last position, 2 A has occurred. So, how do we calculate this? We can initialize everything with 0. And whenever we encounter an A, we increment the count by 1 and add the previous count. So for example, it was 0 initially. So for the case of 0, it matches with A, so we increment it to 1. We come to B, we see that it's not equal to A, so we will keep the count of its previous index, that is 1. We come to C, we see that it's not equal to A, so whatever is the previous count, that is count of previous index, we take it same. Now we come here, we see that it's A and we are looking for A. So whatever is the previous index value, add 1 to it. And now again here, it's not equal to A. So whatever is the previous value, we store here. So this is the running count array. So let's see how we will write the code. So we are given this function. So we have to complete this function, repeated a string, and it takes the string and n and it will return the number of a's in the string in the first n characters. So this function, repeated a string, takes the string and n. So what we can do, first we need to calculate, we need to initialize the running count array. it will be the length. Size of it will be length, and length is the size of a string, that is s dot length. So create an array of that size and initialize it with 0. Now for running count 0, we will compare if s0 is equal to a, then store here 1, else 0. And then for I equal to 1, 2, I less than len, I plus plus. So we iterate for all characters from second character onwards. First we have already stored in running count. So if s of I matches with a, then what we will do? We will store whatever is the value of running count at index 1 less than it, add 1 to it. If it's not, we will leave . So in this way we have calculated this array running count. Now we need this k and r. So what we will do, k equal to n divided by len and r equal to n modulo len. And then we can say count equal to this running count. So how many a are there in the string we can get by the last value stored in running count, because this is the number of a till the last index. So we can say running count len minus 1 is the last index, and multiply this by k, because this string has completely repeated k times and partially repeated r times. So we can say running count r minus 1, but you need to add a condition here. So this means we are taking the first r characters of the string. So whatever is stored in running count for that index, take that value, and whatever is stored in last index, multiply that by k times. But you need to add a condition here, because this may be 0 modulo, then in this case this will fail, this will error out. So instead keep it in a separate variable, remaining count, and we can say r equal to 0, then 0, else this value. So let's see it in the code. So let's calculate the length of this string. So if first character is 0, A, then we set running count 0 to 1. Otherwise, it's already initialized to 0. Why we are taking a special care of 0? Because we want to run a loop from first character till last character, and we were doing minus 1 the previous index while maintaining running count. We fetch the value of running count at previous index and add 1 to it depending on whether it is A or not. So that's why we are making storing at index 0 separately, and then we can run a loop from 1 So what? So whatever is the value of running count till previous character, we store the same value in current index. And if the current index character is A, then we will just increment the current index count. So this way we have calculated our running count index. Now we will keep a variable k to keep track of how many times the string is repeated in this n, and then we will see how many are remaining characters. So this is simply n divided by len, and then remaining count. So if n is perfectly divided by len, then the remaining count is 0 because we don't need to anything. Otherwise, add the value stored at running count, and then finally total count is equal to k times the string is repeated completely, and we have already calculated the remaining count. So this should be the total count. And finally, we need to return it because the return type is long here. And this returns total count. So first check it on, run this code to see if it passes the basic test cases. So there is some typo here. And again, we have some error. So we have added remaining count. We should write running count here because we are creating the remaining count. So it passes the basic test cases. So let's go ahead and submit the code to see if it passes all the test cases or not. So it passes all the 22 test cases. So I hope you enjoyed the problem. Thank you.